Today on STTOP, we're looking at greenwashing, which I find easier to understand when I look at something like this.
It's a hand wash.
It's green. Green liquid. Green tea extract. And it says organic. So I thought this was a vote for the environment. And when I washed my hands, I'd get a nice, warm, fuzzy feeling all over them. But then I read the small print.
It was very, very small and said things like
cocaminopropyl betaine and sodium lauryl sulfate. Two things that are terrifying and that I just took 18 attempts to pronounce. So how does this happen? Well, it's simple. Companies recognize that we want to buy more environmentally friendly products, but instead of, you know, actually making more environmentally friendly products, they just change the label to make you think it's more eco-friendly. Now let's talk to someone who speaks the truth. Dan Ilic is an investigative humorist. He's a comedian, a filmmaker, a podcaster, and he's known for buying ad space in Times Square to slam Australia's movement on climate change with the tagline, "Cuddle a koala before we make them extinct." He makes sad things funny, and that is what I need right now. Hi, Dan. There are some people that are going to watch this video that might have not even heard of greenwashing. So how do you go about finding the truth?
The number one thing I look for when it comes to signs of greenwashing is usually some kind of green leafy logo or the words carbon free or carbon neutral, because then I instantly know, oh, someone's trying to convince me that they're green. Well, I better have a look at this a little closer.
So what's considered illegal and what are the consequences? A breach of the Australian consumer law includes making false claims about a product or misleading and deceiving consumers. That could be making claims that are vague or stats that aren't supported by evidence. For example, we're going green with paper straws that you can't recycle, or nice wooden chopsticks that you also can't recycle, or saying we'll be net zero by 2025.
Actually, 2050.
Are you feeling confused? Annoyed? Betrayed? Just as a little piece of advice to any of our viewers, how would they maybe go about determining what is true?
You have to trust trusted people. There are some very trusted organizations that work in truth, like respected journalists, respected voices, respected fact-checking organizations. But when you are shopping just for your own benefit, there are websites you can go to, like Flora and Fauna, which is a great New Zealand website. But then there are those who are less trustworthy. And those are the ones that you need to avoid. Do the research to find the good green products. You need to decide the correct facts.
Just so that our audience members can have starting points. It's like, there's so many articles that I've seen. There'll be a claim about some outlandish thing that happened, and then the source link is just another article that's talking about the same thing.
That is how you can manufacture spin. That is the complete way to launder misinformation.
You said two words that I've never heard and that I think are genius. Launder misinformation. How do they get away with that?
Well, yes, this is greenwashing, right? The idea is that you can take a small thing and then you can embellish it to make it appear like a good thing. If a company says they are greener or better for the environment, that's a red flag. Because you're greener doesn't mean you're actually good for the environment. Anything to do with fossil fuels is bad.
Is this like a thing? Are there other people out there that are making waves too?
There are plenty of young people out there who are stepping up and making change in their own little communities. And if you can make change in your family, if you make change in your classroom, make change in your school, make change in your neighborhood, then that is fantastic. And then soon you'll be making change around the country and then around the world.
I really appreciate you being here to talk to me as well. It's been wonderful. And I feel like when I do these things, it will make me realize that I know a lot less than I think I know.
Not at all, Matt. You know a lot. And it's totally fine to ask questions.
Thanks, Dan.
All right, so what are we doing? Spotting greenwashing is a cheat sheet. Watch out for vague words like eco, green, and natural. If you see those, they might not mean anything. Packaging is another thing to look out for. For example, it might say it's recyclable, but what it really means is the tag is recyclable and not the item it's attached to. It's like when your salad says it's low fat, but what it really is talking about is the cucumbers and not the whole salad. Check the labels on your favorite brands and make sure that they're in line with your ethical values. You could use one of the search directories that Dan suggested, or let us know if you found your own site. If you want to take it a step further, have a look at what your family's buying, and you can school them on brands that they could switch to. You can use the hashtag #Stop2030 or #Greenwashing.